You're about to enter the Reb Zone Sports Show on Fox 5.
A special night for the seniors, a record-setting win for the Rebels. Right now in the Reb Zone, the football team makes a statement to bowl suitors. Coach Hauck breaks down the win and what's next. Plus, the running Rebels rebound and fly high in the process. Coach Rice steps in to talk some hoops. Get ready to see 30 minutes of Rebel Red. Fire up the cannon. The Reb Zone is ready to ignite.
Somebody light me up. Ooh.
This is the Reb Zone Sports Show, only on Fox 5.
Good evening and welcome inside the Reb Zone, where tonight we double up on football and basketball. Kevin Bollinger alongside UNLV head football coach Bobby Hauck. Dave Rice will be along in just a few minutes. Now, Coach, earlier this week, a new three-year contract agreed upon for you. Congratulations. Nice to get that done.
Yeah, it's a good thing. As I've said many times, Stacy and I and our family really enjoyed Vegas and being at UNLV, and now we can kind of charge forward trying to achieve the ultimate goal, which is a conference championship here.
Well, a good statement last night made by the Rebel football team as they took on San Diego State from their rivals, if you will, from Southern California. The Rebels certainly came out against the Aztecs like it was a team on a mission.
It's our last ride, boys. It's our last ride. Hey, we need this one tonight. Yeah. We got to get this one tonight. Leave it all out here. 4 years or whatever you put in, leave it all out here right now. Win on me, win on three, 1, 2, 3. You do all with a pain, boy. Trish Marble, me, Trish Marble, 3, 1, 2, 3.
Trish Marble!
We control our own destiny. Let's get on this field and win this game tonight, y'all. Got it? Yeah, y'all with me?
Yeah.
Come on, man, break it out. Win on me, win on 3, 1, 2, 3.
Win.
It was senior night as UNLV honored 18 players who have helped turn the program around. The Rebels were amped and ready to go, but San Diego State went right to the bag of tricks. On the second play from scrimmage, the double reverse flea flicker, and Quinn Kaler goes deep to Colin Lockett for the touchdown, and it was quickly 7-0 Aztecs. UNLV answered right back, driving 65 yards in 3 minutes and 20 seconds, capped by this incredible catch by Devontae Davis. 7-7 just 4 minutes into the game. The defense settled in and Tyler Gaston gets the interception. The Rancho High School product says it's the first of his life and UNLV was in business. But the drive stalled and Nolan Cohorse missed this 23-yard field goal attempt. The D started winning every battle up front and gave the Aztecs nothing. On 4th and 4, Tim Hassan tips the pass away and UNLV took over. Caleb Herring went to work and found Davis for the 46-yard gain down to the 19-yard line. 2 plays later, Herring hits Davis again for the 10-yard score to give UNLV a lead they would never relinquish. On the Rebels' next possession, Herring goes play action and throws downfield for Davis, who goes up to get it and gets free for the 63-yard touchdown, and it was 21-7. San Diego State had 4th and inches at the 46, but the Rebel defense swarms and stuffs and makes another huge stop. That set up Cohorse from 50 yards out for the field goal. It's right down the middle, and UNLV went into the locker room with a 24-7 lead at halftime, dominating on both sides of the ball.
San Diego gets the opening kickoff. They run off a good yard gain on the first play and then the trick play for the touchdown. But after that, your defense really locked down. 88 total yards rushing for the game for San Diego State.
Yeah, it was a big night for the defense, certainly. And they played just great. Bad start. And it was about, 25 seconds into the game. We're down 7-0 and they hit us on a trick play. But, you know, that was a team that has really pounded everybody with their run game all year long. And we gave up 30 rushing yards on the first play and about 50 the rest of the game entirely. So it was a good night for our defense.
And offensively, we saw that balanced attack, even amount of rushing plays and passing plays on the night, and really well-managed drives throughout the first half.
Yeah, we controlled it, moved the chains. We were 50% on third down. Caleb Aaron was great. You know, 6 touchdowns, 1 rushing, 5 passing. Devontae Davis had a monster game again. And the guys up front had a terrific game because San Diego State's hard to protect. They dial up a bunch of different things, and our guys were on the money. It was awesome to watch.
Well, the domination picked right back up in the second half as the Rebels put the finishing touches on an impressive win.
All right, bring it up, fellas. Here we go. Finish on three. One, two, three.
Finish.
Go, go, go.
Let's go.
UNLV had the ball first in the second half and got right to it. Tim Cornett would not be denied on this 17-yard run, pounding his way for a first down. Then Herring finds an opening and sprints his way down to the five. On the next play, Herring goes right up the middle for the touchdown to make it 31-7 and sending the crowd into a frenzy. Once again, the defense came up big. Mike Horsey getting in on the action with this interception in return. Into the fourth quarter, the Rebels had 15 minutes left and wanted to make a statement. Herring gets flushed out of the pocket and heaves it downfield to Marcus Sullivan, who hauls it in for the 32-yard score to make it 38-13 with 14:35 to go. The Rebel defense squashed any comeback attempts by the Aztecs this week. On fourth and inches, the stop one last time, and Coach Howe celebrates as chest bumps were flying. Then some history on several fronts. Herring hits Davis for another touchdown, Davis's fourth TD catch of the game, tying a single game mark and giving him a record 14 on the season. Herring's fifth touchdown pass also tied a record, and with the extra point, Nolan Kohorst broke the UNLV scoring record with 245 points, a 40-year-old mark. The Rebels leave no doubt they are a bowl team. 45-19 the final, ending the regular season 7-5, winning five conference games for the first time in the Mountain West, and finishing above 500 both at home and on the road.
It's really surreal coming from 2-11 like so many times where like your confidence is just battered to just nonstop resilience and believing in relentlessness when it comes to, you know, positivity. It's just so rewarding. And it kind of brings tears to your eyes. I'm not going to cry on camera, but it gives you that feeling. It's much earned, well earned. God is good.
With this senior class, I think that we had a decision to make, and you know, we made it. We made it to come back and keep fighting, and to really buy into what Coach Hauck and, you know, the staff was instilling in us. And you know, we kept coming back regardless of what, you know, past seasons dictated and what people outside would say. We kind of just came together and said, look, you know, this is what we want to do. This is what we all came here to do, and we found a way to make it happen our senior year.
Is it possible to put into words how important Caleb Herring has been to this season, not only with his on-field stuff, but the leadership off the field and having that extra coach on the field?
Well, he's been terrific all year long and just such a quality guy and really just a really good example on every aspect of who he is and how he performed this year. So obviously we're excited about him and excited to have him for one more game, it looks like.
We sound like a broken record when we say Devontae Davis had another monster game, because he does. What is it that he is? Is it his relationship with Caleb? Are they reading each other, or is he just running better routes than he has in previous years that he's getting more opportunities?
Well, he's really worked hard. He's better physically. He's better mentally in terms of understanding the game, and he's just making plays. He's a tough guy to deal with because he's big, he's fast, he's good with the football after he catches it. He can break tackles, make people miss, and he's winning on the ball, and that's something to have a little security blanket for that quarterback, knowing he can throw it out there and that guy's going to go get it a bunch of the time is a big deal.
Milestones that we've been ticking off all season long. 6 wins in the previous 3 years combined, 7 wins now for this season. And this was an important one in terms of a bowl game. Bowl eligibility, of course, was 6. But with Fresno State's loss, it certainly wasn't in the bag. Are you feeling more comfortable now as we go into the week before the bowl selections are announced?
Yeah, I'm comfortable. I think we're attractive, win or lose, last night, but obviously that's a big thing. And you know, we've got a good team. We play a good brand of football. Our name is recognizable. A lot of that because of our basketball team, which we're going to get to talk about here in a minute. But people follow us, and we'll be attractive to bowl games, I think.
We're looking forward to hearing what's going to happen. Up next, we're going to switch gears, though. We are going to talk a little Running Rebels hoops. Head coach Dave Rice is going to step into the Reb Zone. He's going to talk about what happened this past week. And we'll also look ahead to Saturday's showdown in Tucson against Arizona. We're back in 2 minutes.
This is the Reb Zone Sports Show, only on Fox 5.
We're joined now by Running Rebel head coach Dave Rice, and a nice bounce back performance by your team yesterday against Tennessee Martin.
It was a total team effort. We played hard. The one thing we've done a very good job of the last several games is playing hard for an entire game. Execution was good. We shared the ball. We were able to get going in transition, and I was very, very pleased with our effort.
Well, let's start looking at the highlights at this one, as the Running Rebels played their final game inside the Thomas and Mack for a couple of weeks, as the National Finals rodeo takes over, but they made sure that they would leave the building on a high note.
The Running Rebels facing Tennessee Martin, and after a 12-point halftime lead, UNLV went on a 15-2 run to open the second half. Kevin Alakabe hit for 3 of his 11 on the game. Then Jalen Kendrick with the nice drive and finish. He had 11 as well. Bryce DeJean Jones put in a solid performance with 16 points, but the fireworks came late. Roscoe Smith gets the hoop and the harm, 13 points and 19 boards for the big man who leads the country in rebounding. The razzle dazzle here with the alley-oop to Kim Birch, and the play of the night, Birch with the steal. The no-look pass to BDJ, who lobs it back for the stuff. As good as it gets right there as UNLV rolls to a 30-point win, 85-55.
The guys, we all were devastated by those losses, but I mean, we just used it as fuel to fire and just kept working hard during practice, before and after practice. And we just looked to come out here and try to make a statement.
We really saw glimpses of what you want to do on both ends of the floor last night. I know things haven't really dictated for you to be able to do that in some of the early games, but yesterday that was Running Rebel style.
Well, absolutely. And we have good players. We have good kids who've worked hard. And the one thing that has remained strong throughout is our team cohesion. And it gives us a chance to be a very good basketball team by the time conference play rolls around. I was very, very pleased with how hard we practiced this week. A couple tough losses, obviously, were coming into the game, but very pleased with our effort yesterday.
Balanced scoring we saw in both games last week with a lot of guys in double digits. How important is that to get a lot of players that can hit everywhere in terms of other teams' defenses trying to figure out what they want to do?
Well, with 9 new faces this year, it takes some time to figure out rotations. It takes time for guys to figure out how to play together. We knew it was going to be a little bit of a struggle. We had some injuries early, but at the same time, we've bounced back. And again, we've practiced hard and we've stayed together. And again, that gives us a chance to have a very good basketball team this season.
Well, the Running Rebels had a game earlier in the week as well, and UNLV couldn't close the deal in a disappointing loss to Illinois.
A sense of urgency in the air as Illinois rolled into the T&M. This was tight throughout the first half, but the Running Rebels went on an 11-2 run, highlighted by Chris Wood getting the hoop and the harm. The Illini stay close. Watch this alley-oop to Joseph Bertrand that gives the Illini the lead. UNLV, though, was sharp in the first 20 minutes. Kendall Smith to Roscoe Smith for the slam, and then a pair of threes by Kevin Olakabe. Kim Birch put on the finishing touches with this slam. A balanced scoring first half for UNLV and a 39-29 lead at the break. The second half was an entirely different story. Illinois opened with a 15-5 run, capped by this alley-oop that tied things up with 44 with 13 minutes to go. UNLV continued the struggle with the zone defense and went cold. Bryce DeJean Jones gets the drive and the lay-in to go as it was back and forth down the stretch. tied at 59 with under 30 seconds to go. Gravonte Rice goes inside and gets the bucket for the two-point Illini lead. Last chance for the Rebs. BDJ loses control of the ball. Olakabe gets off a three-pointer, but it won't go. And UNLV pays for a poor second half and loses a heartbreaker, 61-59.
Let's talk a little bit about the zone defense, and I know it's a question that you've been getting a lot. Well, we talked a couple of weeks ago, you talked about how important it was to get touches inside. The first half against Illinois, it looked like you got a lot of those. The second half, it seemed it stayed on the perimeter.
You know, interesting thing from a statistical standpoint, and we chart everything, is that we're actually scoring at a higher efficiency rate against zone defense this year than we are against man defense. I know that would surprise a lot of people, but we've gotten better at that. We were pleased with our effort in the Illinois game. The energy in the building was fantastic, and just as a group, we're learning how to close games, and it takes a little bit of time for that, but we have a good basketball team. We're showing things up, and we're going to be fine. We're very, very confident about the future.
The free throw situation seems to have obviously improved, and I don't want to say it's fixed itself because I know how hard those guys worked at putting up a ton of shots. Last week, both games, though, free throw shooting was excellent.
It was, and I've talked about it, the fact that we've got guys who have track record of either at a previous institution shooting well from the free throw line or at UNLV in previous years. Just one of those things that we need to continue to work at. We don't talk about it a whole lot. We shoot a lot of free throws. We're very confident going to the line moving forward.
Arizona coming up. It's the only game this week for the Runnin' Rebels. Obviously, they're one of the best teams in the country. They just beat Duke to win their tournament with the preseason NIT. What is it about Arizona that is going to give UNLV the best chance to win? How are you going to approach this game?
Well, they're a top five team. They just beat Duke. They're undefeated. They got a great home court advantage. You know, those are the kind of teams we need to play against. Those are the kind of teams that we need to do well against. I mean, you think about our first 2 years having won 51 games and beating seven ranked teams, getting two NCAA tournaments, and yet we're not even close to satisfied. We've recruited well. This is an elite program that we're trying to build, and these are the kind of programs that we need to play against. We've got a four-year series with them. We play Duke next year. We play at Kansas next year. We've got a variety of other games. We understand how competitive the Mountain West Conference is. And we've got guys who want to be good, who want to work hard, who want to stay together and make this into an elite program. We've got a ways to go to do that, but we're going to get there.
Sometimes when you have a team that hasn't played together like these guys have for a long period of time, is a road game almost beneficial? Maybe a bonding experience with the travel and everything, first one of the year?
Well, without question, the way we structure our schedule every year is we have to play a lot of home games early. We'd like to play a few more road games early, but obviously the National Finals Rodeo comes in here, and we understand how important that is to our school. And so we're out of the building for 17 days, and we understand that. We accept that. And so once we get the home games, we go on the road, but it's good for us. It's good for us to play road games, conference play. Half the games are at home, half the games are at home. And it's just a situation where one of our goals every year is to be competitive and to try to win a regular season conference title. You think about it, in the last 22 years, UNLV's won one regular season conference title. That's a goal for us every single year.
Well, we're going to be in Tucson with the Runnin' Rebels this weekend. We'll have much more on that next week in the Reb Zone. Straight ahead, a rare chance to have both Coach Rice and Coach Hauck together. We're going to talk a little college sports. We're going Reb Zone roundtable style after a Raising the Bar moment.
This Raising the Bar moment is brought to you by Born and Raised, the official home of Rebels on the Road.
UNLV wide receiver Devontae Davis was in beast mode Saturday night against San Diego State. This spectacular one-handed grab in the corner of the end zone was the first of four touchdown catches on the day and is this week's Raising the Bar moment.
You're watching the Reb Zone Sports Show on Fox 5.
Welcome back in the Reb Zone. Coach Hauck, Coach Rice, both joining us. And want to talk a little bit about recruiting. And I know that when you guys go on the road, you have to not only recruit the player, but you have to recruit the parents a little bit. How do you approach the parents and the Las Vegas issue with, outside of Southern Nevada, there's people that think things about Las Vegas, to assure the parents that their kids are going to be good here?
Well, this is a great place. I have the advantage of having gone to school here. I've got 2 degrees from here. I was an assistant coach here for a number of years. It's a great place to live. We've got a vibrant community, great education, dynamic professors, and just I sell all the positives. I believe in UNLV, believe in Las Vegas, and I can't think of a better place for a young man to come and go to school.
Do you get that question?
Well, yeah, absolutely. Oh, absolutely. We get, you know, one thing we have going for us is because of the basketball program, we have some name recognition. Those four letters mean something, and we can get some people's attention. And then, you know, we have to deal with the Vegas thing. But it's certainly something if people let you in the door, they're going to listen to what you have to say and all those things that Dave just mentioned. We have a good place to sell.
And you guys have a good track record with your players, which helps, I'm sure, with the parents. I want to talk a little bit about the conference because college sports is changing so much, it seems like, every year. Are you comfortable with where the Mountain West is situated for both of your sports, that you're going to be able to get into that national picture when it needs to be, whether it be a bowl game or the NCAA tournament?
Well, I know certainly in men's basketball, it's a situation where we had five teams in the NCAA tournament last year and four the year before that, three the year before that, four the year before that. So I think people across the country are seeing what great basketball is played in the Mountain West Conference.
And I'd second that with football. I think it's great football in our league. It's highly competitive every week. These teams go at it tooth and nail, just like they do on the basketball court. It's fun to watch. I think it's a big deal in all of the locales where our universities are located, and it's a strong conference, and it's well run by Craig Thompson, our commissioner.
Now, you guys don't get to see each other during the season that much. What most people don't know is that the UNLV coaches, all of them across the board, you guys are all pretty tight.
We are, and that's the one thing, as we talked, and we have a new athletic director, Tina Kunzer-Murphy, who's done a fantastic job, and as head coaches, we've met with her. And one of the many great things we have going for us is we have a group of head coaches in all sports at UNLV that 100% are together, and that's a huge deal. It doesn't happen every single way, but we go to other teams' games or matches or meets, and we're together. And that's one place where texting actually is a good thing. I can text Coach Hauck, and he can text me. And certainly our wives are both very close, and they confide in one another and go through the challenges of being a head coach's wife in a pretty difficult situation.
At the texting thing, you get texts a lot with each other, right?
We do. It's fun, you know. For me, I mean, the Running Rebs have a lot of fans. So they got a big one in me, so I get to, once recruiting's over, it's 1st of February, I get to be a dang fan, which is kind of fun. And obviously, Dave gets to a lot of our games in the fall, and we have a good working environment at our department, for sure.
Well, we're going to take one final break. We're going to come back with the UNLV Plays of the Week. But first, here's a look at how other Mountain West teams did at both football and basketball over the weekend. Thanks so much for joining us inside the Rep Zone. Coach Hauck, Coach Rice, thanks for stepping in and doing a dual show with us. Have a great week, and we are going to leave you with the UNLV Football and Running Rebel Plays of the Week. Good night.
Look, if you had one shot, one opportunity to seize everything you ever wanted in one moment, would you capture it? Just let it slip.
You better lose this house in the music. The moment you own it, you better never let it go. You only get one shot. Dude.